But I think that's pretty much it. Catch you guys next time. Oh no! Get smacked! So today's video, I'm going to be teaching you guys the top 5 easiest scooter tricks that you could probably learn in like 10 to 15 minutes. Now I would say to make it 15 to 10 minutes or whatever the time margin may be, you probably want to have some experience on a scooter. Granted, you could do it with absolutely none, but it'll be difficult or more difficult. So that's what we're going to do. I'm back at my local. I haven't been here in a long time when I'm actually going to ride. And by the way, next video, if you guys are watching this when it comes out, Woodward, I'm at Woodward right now when you guys are actually watching this. This is my last day, I believe. I think this is the last Friday in August that this is going to come out. But the next bunch of videos are going to be from Woodward, and I think Raymond's there, so hopefully if he's down, we can do some collabs or whatever it may be. Woodward is always a great time. It's going to be crazy. Some crazy stuff's going to happen, and we're going to have a great time, and I'm going to film it because that's what I do for you guys so you guys can watch. But anyway, we're going to go to the GoPro, ride a little bit, take it easy because like I said, it's 99 degrees out, there's nobody here, and I'm just fresh off of like a pretty severe injury, so we're gonna go to the GoPro, warm up a little bit, have some fun, and then get into these 5 tricks that'll take you probably 15 to 10 minutes to learn. Here we go. Holy cow, this feels so weird. I haven't ridden like a skate park ramp, like a big one. This is not really that big, but like you got the idea. I haven't ridden big ramps or medium-sized ramps, as you could say, in so freaking long. Oh, this feels so crazy, dude. Holy moly. Dang, it is blazing hot though. Like, holy crap. Dude, freaking devil's booty cheeks are wide open right now because of this heat. Believe it or not, since my injury, I haven't ridden this park in literally probably who knows how long. It's been at least a month, which is so sad. But about 3 hours after I made the video on this new setup that I'm riding right now, I did flips, or actually you guys saw that in that video, but I did a flare after that on a tiny little quarter. Now doing a flare was actually so weird, not only because I haven't done it in so long, but I just didn't know how to exactly do it. That was the strange part. Holy moly. I think I can do it again. And not only the ramp that I did it on was really small, so I kind of landed flat. Like then again, I don't know if I want to try it again, which I probably should, but like I also got to go back and relearn the tricks I haven't done. Like that one, I haven't done that one since freaking forever. 270 into this. Ugh. Oh yeah, let's go. That's what I'm talking about. Feels good, baby. Woo. Oh yeah. Ha. Dude, this is the best thing ever. You guys don't even know, unless you've actually been injured like this and finally come back freaking ages later. Like I said, it's 99 degrees out, maybe even more than that, and I have no baby powder. My hands might get slippery, which is not the move. Not trying to get absolutely folded, because I'm straight trash and I don't feel like bringing baby powder to the skate park, which I probably should have. Okay, I think the 3 goals that I want to do is flare. I'm tempted to try and stall that gate, and I also want to hit this handrail. We'll start with the handrail because that's probably the easiest. All right, well, I don't know how this impact is going to feel, but we're going to try. That's not too bad. I thought it would be worse, if I want to be completely honest with you. Okay, well, that's trick number 1 checked off the list. Oh, haven't done that one yet either. Woohoo, look at that, new learns right off the bat. Let's go, blunt. Ah! Considering trying to bri flip, I don't know how it's gonna work. I don't know which part's gonna hurt, the flick of it or the landing. I don't know, we'll see. I'm hoping it's neither. It could be both or one or the other, but neither is what we're looking for. All right, we'll see, here we go. First try, come on, commit to it. Oh, yay! Let's go, first one of those air in a while. Now, buttercup air is probably not likely because that's like, oh yeah, nope. That one hurts a little bit, it's still pretty stiff. Late bars also hurt a little bit. Well, by that I mean like after a trick. Like if I did like a whip bar, that would hurt. Matter of fact, you know, I'll try a whip bar. I'll just do a fly out though. I'm not trying to get smacked. Here we go. Full speed-ish, not killed him. Oh yeah, that was pretty good. That wasn't like effortless, like I could feel it was definitely pulling itself, but that wasn't too bad, it could have been worse. Whew. Definitely not that bad though, I've made some progress since I first started riding again on Monday, which was like 3 weeks for you guys. Oh God. Minus the bri flip, that was probably the hardest technical trick that I've done so far. Wah! Woo! Nosey. Oh yeah, I got the nose, man, he's back. Let's go, 50 more. Okay, I think I want to try the stall the gate thing. I don't know how this is going to be, because normally this doesn't take a lot of like physical strength. It takes a lot more speed than you'd think. I definitely think I could do it. I'm just not like
100% sure, but okay. I think that's good enough. I'm definitely expecting to feel this one like a lot more than my other wrist. RIP Roman, that wrist broke 2021. That is big facts. I got absolutely folded like an omelet. By the way, if you guys want folded shirts, links in the description. Go grab those shirts while you can. We also got straight trash shirts and a couple hats. Oh, almost got smacked. Anyway, here we go. See if this works. Hopefully I don't get smacked like a... Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that was light as frick. I thought that would be 20 times harder. Oh God, went a lot better than I was anticipating, which is a great sign. Right, I'll probably do the flare right about here. This is the scariest one for me. Not because I don't know how to do it, I'm just worried it's gonna hurt a lot, but we're gonna try it anyway. Praying my slippery grips don't slip, because the one thing that I really need right now, minus water, is baby powder, and I don't have the baby powder. Boom, I probably don't wanna go that fast, but, oh God, I'm getting nervous now. Oh, my heart's pumping. Okay, we need one more run up. Probably not go that fast. That was actually way too fast. All right, we'll probably do it like right there. Yeah! That was not painful. Let's go. Got a flare. That's what I'm talking about. That was a good one too. I got that again, hold up. Okay, this is the last trick and then we're gonna get into these top five tricks that are like super easy. Woo, yeah, let's go. Okay, so now here are the top five easiest scooter tricks you could probably learn in like 10, 15 minutes. Okay, we'll start off with one of the easier ones. So, say you can tail whip already. You can do it flat. You can do all that good stuff. But you wanna be able to take it to ramps and you're not really into doing it over stuff because you're afraid of the landing. So I mean like this, you can tail whip out of this bank, but you wanna be able to do it over the whole pyramid like this. Just like that. You want to be able to do that, but you're afraid of the landing. So the easiest way to learn and get closer to that goal of yours, learn how to do that trick into the bank. So learn how to tail whip into the bank, which is scarier than doing it out of the bank because you land in a downslope. And depending on how steep your bank is, you want to go not too fast, not too slow, because if you go too slow, you're just going to end up doing something like this. And that's not gonna help you at all. Just find a speed that's not inside your comfort zone, but not like out of the world and out of your comfort zone. Because you have to remember, to make it over this, you have to be going decently fast. You can't go like 2 miles an hour and clear it. And this will take you probably no time because you can already do the tail whip flat. So you can already do this, which involves no decline. So you have more time when you're going down because you land farther down. So your best bet to learn it is either come at it like this at a normal speed, boom, or you can just start at the top. Just like chill up here, give it a good push. Whip it and boom, this way you're used to landing and landing with speed. So that's number one. You can do that with almost any trick. Like if you're trying to learn how to do a 360 over something, learn how to 360 into a landing so you know how to do it off of a takeoff. Okay, so that's number one. That's more of a park trick. Now if you want to do something street and learn something street super easily, say you can do the most basic grind there is on a scooter, a feeble. 50-50 is probably the easiest trick that you can learn right off the bat, just like that. As long as you have a wide enough deck, but you can legit learn this on like a teeny tiny ledge just like this, and you takes like 5 or 6 tries, me missing. You didn't see that, like this, just like that, 50, boom. All it takes is about 10 to 15 tries, maybe 5 minutes you can get this done, and if you know how to feeble good enough. To learn it, you might wanna go slower, so you can just hop on it, and it's legit just like this. Your back wheel and front wheel are hanging, and you're grinding about a third of the deck. That trick takes very little time, and all you have to do is you can try it anyway. You can try it on the curb. You could try it going 0 miles an hour. Just get into it, and then you can learn how to slide just by going faster. Now, if you naturally like front feeble just like that, you can pretty much do the same thing and just do front 50. It's not that much different. It's legit just the other side of your deck, just like that. All right, so the third trick on our list is also like one of those tricks that will impress your friends, and it's also pretty easy to learn. Say you can 180, pretty simple, just like this, like that, 180, half cap. Now, there's a way to make yourself look 10 times cooler and more skilled with like almost no effort at all. So what it's called is a nose pivot 180. Very simple, it sounds exactly how it is. You go up a ramp, you pretty much just take your back wheel off the ground as you're carving, and you don't even have to balance in the nose manual that much. It'll just spin you right around, you land in fake. Now the best way to learn this is probably flat, but the coolest way to do it is on a ramp. So you literally just go up and you just kind of balance on your front wheel for like a split second, and you just carve your back around and you land in fake. This trick is more common in flat, but if you can do it on ramps like that, way cooler, and then you can front side out because you're just that street, you know. But it's legit, like you just pick your back wheel up and you spin. You just carve a little bit, not too much. If you carve too much, this is what's gonna happen. If you yank your back end too far out, you just end up doing a 360, which is 10 times cooler, but the idea is to make it easier, which 360 out of that is a little harder. Okay, here's another one. This one's actually really cool, and you can do it almost anywhere if there's a ramp. Now, personally, I think doing this on a bank is easiest, but you literally go up a bank and you Smith grind it. It's super simple, it looks cool, and it's really fun to goof around with. So depending on your stance, you literally go up to the side of a bank, chink, Smith, and half cab out. As long as you can half cab, you're good. And if you're really feeling it, you can slide a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Just like that. It's very easy, very fun. You can do it front side, whatever it may be. Boom. Just like that. Just little chinks that look cool and are easy. You can legit do it on almost any ramp. Like, boom. You can do it front side on one of these ramps. Boom. Okay, now the last trick on this list is probably the hardest one of them, especially, well, it really depends on your level. Now, this is like one of the most popular scooter tricks there is, even though it's like not the basic ones. It's literally just key whips. Now, the best part about it, it's easier than a tail whip, but it also is harder to learn, I guess you could say. But once you learn it, it's literally the trick you do after any clip you get. Say you get like a flare triple whip, you just do a heel whip flat. Everybody does that because it's so easy. If you can tail whip just like that, it's super easy. It's literally just the opposite way. Most people use the same foot, so if you front foot tail whip, you front foot heel whip. The best place to learn it is probably on a bank, just like this. You could do it on a quarter, just like this. You can do it really anywhere. The hardest way to do it is probably air, because it comes down heel slide. But it just adds the style to tricks. Like, just heel whip. Boom. Do a feeble. Boom. Heel whip. Now, like I said, out of all those tricks, that one will probably take the longest because it's the opposite of what you're used to trying. All right, so those are probably the five easiest tricks that you could legit learn in, like, absolutely no time. Like, legitimately, if you spend like an hour, maybe a little bit more at the skate park trying to learn all those, you have five new learns in one day, which is great. But yeah, if there's any specific tricks that you guys want me to try and teach you in a video, let me know down in the comments below and I'll definitely consider it. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, but I think that's pretty much it. Catch you guys next time. Oh no, get smacked. All right, I'm out of here. I'll catch you guys next time. Later.